Assalamualaikum. My name is Widi Mutakin. I am an entrepreneur and also a lecturer in computer graphics disciplines. I teach 3D and 2D animations, web designs, motion graphics, game development, and other computer graphics related disciplines. I've been using and teaching 2D SMAX for over 2 decades now. Since 2003, I've created thousands of images like this. I have worked with clients all over the globe in the architectural industry. I have clients in almost every continent that exists in the world. Long story short, besides being a teacher, I am also an experienced professional in the field of computer graphics, especially architectural visualization. Now, onto the big question. What will you get from this course? In this online course, you will learn how to use 2D SMAX and Corona Renderer to create an interior scene from scratch. If you never used 2D SMAX before, or even used any 3D software before, don't worry, because we will start from level 0. We will cover the essentials, and then move up gradually to the more advanced stuff. This is the final result of the interior project that you will create in this course. I guarantee you, inshallah, you will be able to create this 3D rendering if you follow the course from start to finish. Besides access to the lesson videos, you will also get the project files. They are 3D SMAX files with all the related files such as textures and Photoshop files. There are so many things that you will learn from this course. It will be too long to explain all of them in this short video. You can check the curriculum section if you want to dig deeper. But just for a quick preview, there are a total of 15 chapters in this course. In the first chapter, you will learn the UI of 3D SMAX. You will learn viewport navigation and different display settings. In the second chapter, you will learn basic object operations such as creating, modifying, transformations, selecting, duplicating, etc. In the third chapter, you will learn scene management techniques such as using the scene explorer, using layer, grouping, etc. In the fourth chapter, you will start learning 3D modeling using the editable poly object. You will learn different ways to create selections and many different modeling commands such as extrude, inset, bevel, bridge, connect, cut, slice, and so on. Next, in chapter 5, you will learn precision modeling techniques. You will learn how to use the real measurement units, learn to use snapping, object alignment, etc. Then, in chapter 6, you will start working on the interior project. You will model the picture frame, the coffee table, the TV, the shelves, the floor, the wall, the ceiling, the door, and the window. In chapter 7, you will learn 3D modeling using spline objects. You will learn different spline vertex types. Learn to create splines and modify them using many different techniques. And then learn to use modifiers to convert the splines into 3D objects. In chapter 8, you will continue working on the interior project. You will create the curtain, the floor lamp, the 3D pattern, the backdrop, the crown molding, the plinth, the loudspeaker, and so on. In the next chapter, or chapter 9, you will learn the basics of subdivision modeling techniques. And then, in chapter 10, you will apply the subdivision techniques to model a teacup object, and then model the sofa for the interior project. You will start with the leg, then the seating, the cushion, and finally the backrest part. In chapter 11, you will start learning how to use materials, starting from the basic concepts, how to use the material editor, material map browser, using multi-sub-object material, creating your own material library, and so on. In chapter 12, you will learn the essentials of the Corona Renderer, learn how to create different lighting types, learn to use the Corona physical material, Corona interactive rendering, render element, masking, etc. In chapter 13, you will continue the interior project. You will add the Corona camera to the scene, adding the environment lighting, and then the interior lights, and also adding basic materials. Next, in chapter 14, you will learn texturing and UV mapping. Learn how to use PBR textures with the Corona material, UV projection mapping, UV unwrapping, and the real-world map size feature, etc. Finally, in Chapter 15, you will add textures to the interior scene. You will learn how to use the Corona Material Library, add custom PBR textures to the floor and carpet, learn how to optimize instantiated multi-sub-object materials, learn how to UV unwrap the armchair model, and then finally, render the project and create the final composition in Photoshop. After completing the course, inshallah, you will have solid skills in using 3ds Max and Corona Renderer. You can apply the skills later not only for interior projects, but also for other architectural visualization projects in general. I hope you find this course interesting and beneficial. Wassalamualaikum.